In this week's episode, our guest host, Nadia Evers, travels to Germany to witness a young Malaysian racing in a German Formula 3 series.
Hey guys, or should I say, Guten Tag. This is Eurospeedway Lausitz. I'll be speaking to our very own PETRONAS talent development driver, Nabil Jeffri, and it's a race you don't want to miss.
And in our Through the Chicane segment, Ramdan Rosli talks candidly to me about his new team in Spain.
Hey guys, join me right here in Le Mans to talk to none other than your favorite rider, Ramdan Rosli, and his new team in the Spanish Championship. I'm Julie Woon.
I'm Nadia Evers.
And you're watching Motorsports
at PETRONAS.
Germany has always been in the forefront of automotive engineering. It's no wonder then that this is the home of the prestigious ATS Formel 3 Cup. The German Formula 3 first started in the western part of the country in 1950. This is one of the best platforms for a four-wheel race car driver to develop his racing skills. And this year, 10 drivers from 7 countries will partake in the championship. One of them is Malaysia's very own Nabil Jeffri.
Muhammad Nabil Jan Al Jeffri is no stranger to the motorsport scene in Malaysia. He's also making waves right here in Germany. This is his second year as the PETRONAS talent development driver, and this program is aimed at nurturing and developing young Malaysian talents through partnerships with strategic championships and teams.
This year, Nabil will be racing with Team Motopark. The 2014 season consists of 8 rounds, and today, Nadia will be watching the race right here at the Eurospeedway Lausitz.
The Eurospeedway Lausitz has been hosting various racing events since the year 2000, and it is a very special circuit. It is the only place in continental Europe to have a high-speed tri-oval racing track. And to top it all off, the entire circuit can be seen right here from the main grandstand.
The stand around the tri-oval circuit has a capacity of 120,000 spectators. Another special feature? A single wind turbine powers this whole circuit. Talk about green motorsports technology.
Hey Nabil,
hey.
So how are you?
I'm good.
So this is Eurospeedway Lausitz.
Yes.
How do you like it so far?
I like the track, not my favourite, but then I think I could do well here. It's quite a nice environment here.
Yeah, I think so too. So this is your second year with the PETRONAS Talent Development Programme.
Yes.
How has it developed you as a four-wheel single-seater racer?
As a person, I think I've been better because without them, I wouldn't be here and wouldn't be experiencing what it is in Europe to be racing here. And I'm very proud to be a Malaysian here. And last year I was the only Asian here, but this year I'm with another Malaysian. And I think comparing to last year, I've improved a lot.
Now, I'm not very familiar with the German Formula 3. Could you explain how it works, like the qualifying and how many races there are in a weekend?
There are going to be 3 races in one weekend. It starts with on Thursday. Thursday is where you have official practice. And Friday is when the qualifying and practice again. And Saturday is race 1 and race 2. And Sunday is race 1, race 3, sorry.
So there's one qualifying but 3 races. How does that work?
Yes, because the first race is actually from the best from your first qualifying. And the race 3 is from your second best of the qualifying. And race 2 is from the finishing order of race 1, but you reverse it. Like number 1 till number 8, you reverse.
I see.
So whoever finished first in race 1, they'll start 8 in race 2.
Oh, okay.
So it's like that.
So you've been racing all across Asia, and now you're racing amongst Europe's finest young talents.
Yeah.
Is there a difference between racing in Asia and now here?
So I think for me, the biggest difference in Europe and Asia is huge, because last year when my first year in Europe, I was 7, 8, 9, 10 and sometimes. And this year I've improved. I've been in the top 3 positions for quite some time. And yeah, I think it's nice to be racing among the best in Europe.
Yeah, it's a big improvement actually.
Yes.
So, you're with the motor park team,
yes,
which is the German team.
Yes.
Is there a language barrier?
Yeah, of course, but they do speak really good English, so that's not a big problem. But I try to improve myself to learning like new languages, like German language, French and stuff like that.
So you can speak a little bit of German now?
I can speak the important things, but not everything, yeah.
So you're based in Malaysia?
Yes, but I'm mostly here in Germany, because usually it's like 6 weeks in Germany and 2 weeks in Malaysia.
So when you're in Malaysia,
yeah,
how do you and your team engineers keep in touch to discuss strategies?
Nowadays it's quite easy because we have WhatsApp and we have our own group in like WhatsApp and others. And we still communicate through emails, and I know the latest development of the car and everything regarding racing. So yeah, I'm quite well prepared in that sense.
Great. So you obviously have a very supportive family.
Yeah, of course.
But how are they when you're out there racing on the track? Can they watch?
Yeah, they can watch. It's up to them. But sometimes my mom, she's a bit scared to watch because she gets like heart attack.
She's nervous.
Yeah, sudden heart attack. But then I think I like it when I know they're watching me. You know, I really feel the support from them.
Of course.
Like
you've got the whole of Malaysia supporting you.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, what goes through your head during a race? Are you reciting the corners, or are you relaxed enough to sing your favorite song?
No, I can't sing for sure. But obviously I'm thinking about the next corner. But sometimes I just don't think too much, because by thinking too much, you just actually, I don't know, for me it's...
You lose focus?
Yeah, I lose focus if I think too much. So I just let it flow, get it in the flow, and just do whatever I feel. It comes naturally usually for me. So I don't have to think too much, and I just drive according to my feelings.
Now, if you weren't a racer, what would you be doing?
I have a lot of things I want to do. First, I want to fly a plane myself. And first, I want to buy a plane and fly a plane. And other than that, I want to be an engineer, I think. I know since young, I love to do anything with cars, everything that has to do with cars. And yeah, but the most important thing for me, I like to fly a plane, I think. It's quite cool.
Well, thank you so much, Nabil, for the insight on the German Formula 3 and for letting me get to know you a little bit more.
Sure.
I know you got a busy schedule with the scrutineering and the track walk, but before you head back to your racing machine, I have another kind of race that I want to challenge you to.
Let's do it now.
Yeah. So come with me and I'll show you what I mean.
Let's go.
Ta-da! It's our RC race.
Yes.
So here's what we're going to do.
Okay.
You have to make the figure 8 with the RC car while I blast you with a 10-word association.
Okay.
First thing that comes to mind, and I'm going to time you, and then I'll do the same, and we'll see who can steer the RC car.
So the shortest one wins, yeah?
Yes, okay. Definitely. All right, so you go first,
yep,
and I'm going to start timing you,
okay,
starting now. Paradise.
Leisure.
Funny.
Me.
Lubricant.
Petronas Intium.
Race.
Formula One.
Circuit.
Hockenheim. Sepang.
Hat.
Hat? No hat.
Malaysia.
Malaysia? Colourful.
Drive-through.
Hopefully not this weekend.
Speed.
Formula One again.
Jump.
What do you think about jump? Bungee jumping.
And stop.
Stop? I don't know what stop. Am I slow?
38. Okay, so now it's my turn. You're gonna time me.
Okay.
And I'll and I'll give you the 10 words.
Okay. Okay, you can start now. Lubricant.
Oil.
Race.
Car.
Circuit.
Lausitz.
Lollipop. Come on, lollipop.
Oil.
Okay, jump.
Bear.
A bear jumping, okay. Speed.
Fast.
Motorsports.
Bikes.
Happy.
Sad.
Sky. I'm asking you all now. Last one. Radio.
Car.
43 seconds.
Well, that was fun, Nabil. Thank you so much. I'll let you get back to your team now.
Yes.
As the motorsports world in Malaysia is rapidly growing, the thirst to see young, talented Malaysians racing in the international community is also evident. And now we finally get to see and reap the benefits from the PETRONAS Talent Development Program. I'm Nadia Evers.
And I'm Nabil Jeffri.
And this is Motorsports at PETRONAS.
PETRONAS, as technical partner to the Mercedes-AMG PETRONAS Formula One team, developed PETRONAS Premax with advanced energy formula for superior fuel efficiency to achieve the Formula One target of the same power output using 30% less fuel. This year, Formula One engines have been downsized to a 1.6-litre turbocharged direct injection V6 hybrid, bringing Formula One more in line with everyday vehicles. This is why we designed PETRONAS Premax 95 with advanced energy formula for everyday users. This year, Formula One fuel consumption has been reduced by 30% to a maximum race fuel allowance of 100 kilograms per race. This desire is similar and more in line with everyday vehicles. In fact, from last year to this year, we save around 50 kilograms per race, which amounts to the weight of the mineral water on the table over here. The Mercedes Formula One engine is developed together with PETRONAS Premax fuel and PETRONAS Syntium engine oil as part of PETRONAS Fluid Technology Solutions and is the fuel and engine oil for Mercedes-AMG PETRONAS Formula One team. For everyday vehicles, we have the PETRONAS Premax 95 with advanced energy formula and PETRONAS Syntium, such as the PETRONAS Syntium 7000 engine oil.
Many of the world's best begin their careers in the Spanish championship Campeonato de España de Velocidad Repsol. It is undoubtedly the best route into MotoGP. Many of the top riders such as Marc Marquez, Scott Redding, Jorge Lorenzo and Casey Stoner all came through it. In fact, Malaysia's very own Hafiz Syahrin had a shot in the championship. But this year, in 2014, it is Ramdan Rosli's turn to make his mark in CEV Repsol. With participants from 23 different countries, the CEV Repsol is a great platform that welcomes talented riders from all over the world to learn their trade in one of the most professional environments outside the FIM Road Racing World Championship Grand Prix. Ramdan Rosli is one busy rider. Since relocating to Barcelona to fully focus on his new championship, he has been under the radar. But lucky me, I managed to catch him right here in Le Mans for his race in CEV Repsol. Hi Ramdan, apa khabar?
Ya, yeah, baik.
Yeah, you?
Okay, baik.
This exciting times for you. But first and foremost, tell us a little bit about your bike.
So this season, I will use the racing bike. Mm-hmm. Is Moto3. Is more different than the Asia bike.
Okay.
Between the chassis and the bike, also more different. The Moto3 is the fully racing bike, and the I use in the last year is the road bike. So maybe like street bike now.
Oh, so now it's more challenging lah.
Yes.
But you like it lah, if yeah. It's more challenging. Oh, okay. And I also noticed, because I'm also a fan of 99, if you know who I'm talking about, you used to compete with the number 99 after your idol Jorge Lorenzo. But now I notice you changed to number 93.
This year, I use number 93 because in Spanish Championship, the Spanish rider already use the 99 number, so
you're talking about Jorge.
I don't choose to use 99 number, so I choose to use the 93.
I see. So how's it like racing in Spain compared to racing in Asia?
Racing in Spain is more different because like weather in Europe is like cool, and then in Asia you remember the weather is hot and then rain, so this is different.
But do you prefer it in Spain then, since the weather is nicer?
Yeah, nice, cool and enjoy.
The food and all that. It's obviously a whole new ball game for you. New championship, new pit crew. What's the relationship like with your new team?
Yeah, this year I work with the Spanish team. Yeah, more different between the last year. So the first year with the Spanish team for me is not difficult because I like the Spanish more happy and enjoy.
It looks like it's a good relationship between you and your new crew. Yeah. So perhaps you could introduce me to them?
Yeah, then.
All right, let's go to your pit. Jom.
Okay, this is my pit.
Oh, your pit, so cute.
Yeah, my pit and let I introduce my pit and also my team. Okay, Kenny, that's my team member.
Hi, Kenny.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very good. You are the team manager?
Yes.
I see. So what does a team manager do?
We'll take care of my rider, Ramdan, the fitness.
Yeah,
And the food. Then he sets aside all the things.
Is he a difficult person to take care of and to manage?
For his...
Honesty?
Yeah.
Yes, ah. Difficult, ah?
Earlier.
Oh, earlier? Why? What? Tell us some story. Why was he difficult?
Very naughty.
Really? But he looks so calm and obedient.
Yeah.
But looking at him, he's so calm. He's, you know, I think he can do it. He's dedicated.
He can if he wants.
If he wants. He wants. So now he's easier to manage. That is a good point now.
So far, it's okay.
So far, okay. But keep an eye on you.
Okay, Rasmin.
Rasmin.
I'll leave it to Rasmin.
Okay, cool.
He is our coordinator for me.
Coordinator,
also, yeah.
Rasmin.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Come here to our humble little set.
Right.
So Rasmin, you're the coordinator. What does a coordinator do?
Basically, I did all the planning for Ramdan.
Oh, that's a tough job, huh?
Championship where we test what we do every day. Oh. It's training, so almost everything.
So he's really busy, but you're the busier man.
Yes, I am.
And you knew Ramdan way back when he was in Capri, so that's like years ago.
Actually, when I saw his riding style, his more eagerness to push further, then I think this is someone that we need to push further at that time.
And off the track, is he easy to manage and coordinate too?
Ooh, he's quite tough actually.
Really? I can't even tell. He looks so innocent.
But he's doing all the chores that we planned for him. Going to the gym, running, bicycling,
he looks fit.
Swimming. Now we need to push him a bit further so that he can be at par with the GP rider.
Yeah. Looks like a cozy family here.
Mm, yeah. I think it's good to call the engineer.
Who do you have?
Albert.
Hello.
Are you from Spain?
Yes.
Hello.
How are you?
Very good. Albert, you are the engineer?
Yes.
I see. So how long have you been working together, you know, and how's it like so far being in this team?
I'm in this team since 4 years ago.
4 years?
From the beginning of the team. Before, I've been working in GP since 1999. I have a long experience in GP.
I see.
I've been also in Super Sport World Championship, Superbike World Championship.
I see. So, in your expert opinion, since you've been in the industry for so long, is this the winning team? Do you have a feeling that this team has got what it takes to win?
This team has a very, very good
chance.
Yes.
Good chance of winning.
It's, everything is ready to grow up like a team, try to teach the riders, try to improve everything, the team, the riders, and try to get the best results possible.
So I can't wait to wait to meet the rest of your team. Like, who is that?
So, Jacinto.
Jacinto.
This is our chief mechanic.
Thanks, Albert.
Hi,
Jacinto.
Hello.
How do you like working together with this young man over here?
Yeah, I feel really happy to work this year with him and another Malaysian guy. Yeah, it's okay.
So, what's the hard part about your work? Is it difficult? Yeah. Like, what are some of the challenges?
It's very difficult, but this is a GP bike. I need many work, many concentration. Yeah.
I see. Is it easy working with one another?
Yeah, it's easy.
You sure?
Yeah.
The no good, good mechanic.
Yeah. Yeah. At the moment, step by step.
Who's that?
Fine. Yeah, my mechanic.
Your mechanic. So
mechanic,
you guys work together. Thank you very much.
Terima kasih.
Oh, sama-sama.
Hello.
Hello, I'm Wan.
You're Wan. So what is it that you do here with the team?
Normally, we do a maintenance for his bike, for Ramdan's bike actually. Then we do some light setup for him and advise some riding style, what he need to do during the qualifying practice and the race.
Does he follow instructions well?
So far, he's following good.
Good. How is it like working with a family of from all over the world, basically? There's no, basically, communication barrier, no problems?
Yeah, of course, certain things we have. But for me, I'm stay here for 4 years, last time with MotoGP. So I can speak Spanish, I can speak Malay, I can speak English. So a few Japanese, so not a big problem for me at all.
I see. Yes. Thanks so much, Wan. All the best.
Okay, thank you.
Good luck in your work. Hope to see you again.
Okay, me too.
Thank you. Bye. So I met all of your team members already.
Yeah.
Looking at the team and how tight everybody is, on and off track, I think you got a long way that you can go.
Yeah.
You know, all the best.
Thank you.
Terima kasih.
Terima kasih.
Ramdan Rosli has not even begun wrecking havoc in the Spanish Championship. He has proven that he has got the talent and that he deserves to take a crack at CEV Repsol. And I can't wait when that happens. Don't forget to log on to www.petmos.com.my to find out more about your favourite teams, riders and race results.
Muhammad Nabil Jan Al Jeffri is no stranger to the motorsport scene in Malaysia. Since the year 2000, and it is a very special circuit.
Am I slow?
38.
Can I do it again?
Many of the top riders, such as Marc Marquez, Scott Redding, Jorge Lorenzo, and who else?